Good morning, everyone. I am Vanda. Have you ever thought about the aging problems in your skin before? Actually, our skin is damaged by the UV radiation every day. And it will cause photoaging and wrinkles is formed because of it. And in our skin, there are some antioxidants to against aging, such as the vitamin E and coenzyme Q10. And it is proven that recently, coenzyme Q10 is used in some cosmetic products, such as the hand cream and face mask as shown in the pictures here. And therefore, I'm interested to investigate its function, especially as an antioxidant. And my research topic is how does coenzyme Q10 function as an antioxidant in cosmetic field? So in this presentation, I will first briefly introduce about the human skin and coenzyme Q10, and then I will reveal some previous research and indicating the gap. And lastly, I will focus on the aims, methodology, and the expected results of my own research. So human skin is the largest organ in our body. It has a surface area of about 2 meters square. It is important to us that it protect us from the pathogens, toxins, and the UV radiations. And UV absorption in our skin will cause two problems. First, it will initiate the production of the hydroxyl radicals. It will cause oxidative damages to our lipid proteins and DNA. And the second problem is the photoaging. The collagen fibers will be degraded by the enzyme collagenase, and it will lead to the disorganization of our dermal matrix. Therefore, the aged skin will be characterized by the formation of wrinkles and the lack of tensile strength. And for the coenzyme Q10, it actually functions as the first line of defense in our body against aging. It has two important functions inside our cells. First, it will act as an energizer. It builds up adenosine triphosphate named ATP as stored energy in our skin. And the other function is to act as an antioxidant. It can enhance our resistance of skin by removing free radicals, suppressing the collagenase, and also to against the UV-mediated oxidative stress. However, the coenzyme Q10 level in our epidermis will decrease with age, especially at the age of 30. And therefore, the coenzyme Q10 synthesized by our cell is not sufficient to prevent aging. And it has been reported that coenzyme Q10 is able to penetrate our skin without any adverse effects such as the irritation and staining. So it is safe to use coenzyme Q10, and it thus becomes an important ingredient in the cosmetic products. And it is used to prevent wrinkles, early aging, and the loss of cell activities in our skin. And in some previous research, several research about the topical effects of different forms of coenzyme Q10 has been performed. For example, the properties of the novel coenzyme Q10 nano emulsions, and the occlusive and penetration properties of coenzyme Q10 loaded nanostructured lipid carriers. And also the topical effects of some pure and yeast-based coenzyme Q10 has been investigated. However, in all this previous research, the tested age group is not fully completed, especially at the age of 30 onwards, which the level of coenzyme Q10 has been started to decline rapidly. Therefore, it is a gap that the topical effects of coenzyme Q10 on the age from 30 to 50 are remained unknown. To fill the gap found in the previous research, my research aim is to investigate the topical effects of the coenzyme Q10. I will find about the topical absorption and the antioxidant effectiveness of it. And there are three age groups in our research. They are the young group, which is from the 20 to 29 years old, the middle age group from 30 to 49 years old, and the elder group from 50 to 70 years old. And in the experiment, there will be 20 volunteers of 10 males and 10 females to participate in each age group. And a lotion containing 0.1% coenzyme Q10 will be daily applied on their skin and forearms in the morning and evening for 2 months. And throughout the treatment, the level of coenzyme Q10 in the stratum cornea, which is the outer layer of our skin, will be assessed in every 15 days. And for the topical effects, there are 2 measurements. The first one is to measure the hydrogen peroxide in our skin, and the second one is to measure the depth of the wrinkles. And it will be measured by the use of the microtomography. And there are 3 expected results of my research. Firstly, the coenzyme Q10 absorption should be increased with the age, and a larger absorption is expected to observe in the elder group. Secondly, the hydrogen peroxide in the stratum corneum should be detected in all the tested age groups, and a greater decrease should be observed in the elder group. And the third one is the reduction of the depth of the wrinkles. And also, especially in the middle age group and the elder group, it should be a significant depletion of the wrinkles. And this is the end